pretty amazing, huh?
Mm-hmm.
So this is by Haroshi, mm-hmm. and the title is Mosh Pit.
Mosh Pit.
Right, and again from 2019, so it's a new piece. He recycles old skateboards, mm-hmm. and he's been a huge skateboard fan since he was a kid. Well, it's really interesting because he's had no formal art education. This is all self-taught.
And I heard that he has a big following on Instagram.
I know, it's like 130,000 people on Instagram. He's obviously made a huge impact.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, not just in skateboarding culture, but I think internationally as well. Mm-hmm.
Most of the work in this show has some relation with graphics and illustration.
Yeah. Right.
This has kind of immersed into our culture, pop culture, in the last 2 or 3 decades. And the references are all kind of Western imports of iconography, I guess.
Yeah, it
pop seems culture,
like that.
Underground.
I don't really see any references to Japan at all. I mean, can you see anything?
The only thing I see is Hello Kitty.
Hello Kitty, right, yeah. And of course, the Playboy Bunny. Mm-hmm. You've got that in the very center, right?
That's going to be the overlap.
The inevitable.
The theme of the whole show here,
I know, in a way it kind of is.
We'll see more of that later.
We will see more of that later, yes, we will. Okay, well, shall we go over to these works? Because these are also Haroshi right over here.
I kind of like these a little bit more for its spiritual quality.
Yeah.
It's very different from the one over there that's like a mural. These are objects still using the same medium, which are disposed, maybe damaged skateboard,
right.
Plywood.
And the process is quite difficult.
And even in these forms, more than the mural piece over there, I could see that the artist is finding his way how to form these things. There's no real rule to it, which is very great.
Yeah,
it's
it really
very free form.
Yeah.
Keeps your eye moving.
Yes, yeah, that's
when
true.
You're
looking
at
it. Yeah, it really does.
The layering kind of reminds me of like an old, a traditional crafts from Japan, which is yosegi.
Mm-hmm. You were mentioning something about the spirituality of it.
And they have this craft where they make these boxes and they have secret compartments in it. I think Haroshi also has this hidden little skateboard embedded in these pieces.
Fascinating. All right, shall we move to our next artist? So this piece is by Hiroki Tsukuda, and the title is called Strict Gate.
Strict Gate, okay.
And he created this last year. What's one of the most interesting things I've found about doing research on him, unfortunately I haven't met him, but he's colorblind.
Mm.
So a lot of the work that he does is this sort of black and white, some color obviously in the white parts, but these black and white drawings on paper.
I did read a little bit about him too, and I realized he has reference from science fiction movies and novels, and like Mad Max or Star Wars, or and if it's a Japanese reference, it'll be like the spaceship Yamato. But another thing that came up was it looks like the Darth Vader helmet shape.
Yeah, that's right. It does.
Yeah. I don't know why, but especially now that I see the nuclear warning sign.
Right, yes, exactly. Here, right here, yeah. Is he referencing Fukushima in any way?
I don't know. It very much could be, I think.
I really like his work a lot, and I don't think we've really seen it here, at least in the United States.
This type of work is probably even more abstract than the rest of the work that I see here so far.
Right, yeah, it is, for sure.
Hiroshi's a little bit more playful in a way, and like you said before, even his three-dimensional work that look like effigies, a little bit cartoonish looking, but in this one I see something that's quite the opposite, more like a terror, more realistic.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, dystopian
Life-like,
future.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Shall we go to the next one?
Yes.
All right. So this work is by Hajime Sorayama, and it's titled Sexy Robot walking bronze. Mm-hmm. And again, this was created last year, 2019.
Oh, it was last year. Okay.
Yeah, so it's a brand new piece.
Interesting.
Which is
really
interesting.
Yeah, because I remember growing up with his work in Japan from the 70s, 80s on. And this is kind of like the iconic work that he makes over and over. I wouldn't be able to tell the difference if it's made last year or sometime in the 70s.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah. I understand, though, that it's complicated the way they make these. Mm-hmm. And the first, so he draws the figures on computer, and then followed by, they carve it from a block of styrofoam, and then layers and layers and layers of aluminum paint.
Right.
So getting that sheen is actually really quite difficult.
Mm-hmm. It's kind of like the male gaze of this female form back in that time.
Right.
And also, the other thing that was very popular in the 70s was the supercars that came out, the Lamborghinis and Ferraris. The finish of the cars, where it's all polished and shiny chrome looking. And I think this kind of fuses both those aesthetics.
Well, we've got more of these mm-hmm. to look at in this cordoned off amazing room. So this one is called Sexy Robot Floating. He was always into robots.
Yes.
He's been involved loving robots and drawing them and producing them for at least since the 70s, for sure.
And he's also made some Sony robot.
That's right, the Aibo.
And that's like in the 90s.
Yeah, that was the Sony Aibo robot dog. So he's been kind of on the cutting edge of technology, but mm-hmm. somehow he's kind of gotten a little bit stuck in this 70s, in these sexy robot. It reminds me a little bit of that movie Ex Machina, which was actually a very frightening movie.
Right. Another movie reference I want to make is like Aliens.
Oh, Aliens, yeah. Well, this,
the,
you know, this the, installation.
The monsters and their own capsules. And also, this the other thing that's really interesting, I don't know if he was intending it to be that way, but the Kusama Yayoi installation, the infinity mirrors, is sort of the same effect is happening here too.
Right.
We see, you know, an ongoing series of robots
mm-hmm.
reflecting off of each other.
Mm, that's right, yeah. All right.
Okay.
So,
so you had a story about
something. So this is again Hajime Soriyama. Mm. And he's really got a pretty good sense of humor. Mm-hmm. And he's done a lot of these works with the middle finger up. He's done all this serious robotic stuff and AI.
This is very different from that.
And this is completely different. He's not so intense, right? He's kind of playful.
Not so mechanical.
Right, exactly. So these works are by Harumi Yamaguchi,
mm-hmm.
who created these in the 1970s. She was the Parco department store director of advertising. Yeah, so she was extremely influential during that period.
Right.
So she's 78 years old and really, an inspiration for so many Japanese women artists.
Mm-hmm.
And of course, she is the only woman in this entire show, which is, I'm sorry to say, disappointing.
Right. Yeah, I think Harumi, she is one of the many artists who use airbrush as a medium. Airbrush was very convenient. It's the quickest way to do a realistic rendering of body forms. Aerosols replaced airbrushes, and then it led into the graffiti culture.
Well, I mean, one of the impressions that I have of this works, and I remember also like in the 1980s when I was first living there, is that all the models were all Westerners.
Mm-hmm.
They were all Caucasian, which even at the time I found was weird.
Yeah, well, there's a long fetishism of looking up to Western culture.
I remember so clearly in the 90s, the women finally becoming more empowered and feeling, the Japanese women feeling that they could be themselves. They mm-hmm. didn't have to be some copy of a Western woman.
Exactly, yeah.
But there are so many fabulous Japanese women artists. I would love to see a show, an entire show.
I would love
of
that.
Them. Yeah, yeah, I think Los Angeles.
I think that's something that needs to come up.
Absolutely. Right. Yeah, absolutely. All right. So shall we go and see the next work?
Sure. This is Tanami Keiichi.
Keiichi Tanami. Yeah. So you are super knowledgeable about him. You've met him, right?
Yes. And him along with Yoko Tadanori, the simple graphic forms, as you see in the 1964 Olympics, moved on to more complex forms like this one. Mm-hmm. Taking traditional Japanese patterns, iconic waves from woodblock prints, and combining with a newer palette.
This was actually created last year. In fact, most of the
I heard most of the work here
that he did was all like
about 30 pieces in here.
Yeah,
right.
Around 2018, 2019.
Right. And incidentally, he's the flagship artist of the gallery.
That's Nanzuka, right. He is. Right. Yeah, that's right. That's his story is really incredible, right?
I mean, right.
He grew up during World War II lived through the Tokyo firebombing by the United States.
Yeah, maybe that nightmare exists in Keiichi's work here.
Well, I mean, it just seems to be getting stronger, the nightmarish aspects of his work.
I mean,
whereas before, I mean, there's a piece over here that seems a little, not quite as intense, but let's have a look. Yeah. I mentioned that Tanami did a lot of other works besides painting, and he's done video. It's not video, it was like 18 millimeter film, back then.
Okay.
Referencing a lot of World War II imagery.
So it's like a 60s experimental film that combines animation.
That's right, yeah.
Right, collage work.
That's right.
Right. All right, we're going to go to the final
work. Yes, the final piece
that we're going to talk about today.
So we're still talking about Keiichi Tanami. This is his work. The title is Adventure of the Eyes series.
Right.
Again, this was just created last year, 2019. Uh-huh. I'm looking again at the Playboy reference.
Exactly. I think because being 83-year-old here, probably the oldest in the show here, he has so much reference, which is so rich. To me, he seems like a very complex person, because of this history.
Mm-hmm. Well, this is a great work to end on for our
It really is.
Yeah.
It's really interesting to see all this Japanese work that incorporates everything, really.
Yes.